Want to speak real English from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at EnglishClass101.com.
Hi, everybody. Welcome back to Know Your Verbs. My name is Alicia, and in this episode, we're going to talk about the verb die. Okay, let's begin with the basic definition of this verb. The basic definition of the verb die is to stop living or to stop existing. Examples: she died yesterday. Doctors say he might die within a year. Let's look at the conjugations for this verb. Present: die, dies. Past: died. Past participle: died. Progressive: dying. So now let's talk about some additional meanings for this verb. The first additional meaning for this lesson is to disappear gradually. Some examples: the noise died down a short while after the concert ended. My interest in eating meat died after I watched a documentary. So in both of these examples, something gradually decreased. In the first example sentence, after a concert ended, the noise died down. So actually, we can say died down to, like, it sounds like it was up here, like, because we're using the word down there, it sounds like the volume was up here maybe, and it gradually came down. So the noise died is okay, like the noise died after, but the noise died down sounds even more gradual. So this is sort of like an extra variation on this meaning. In the second example sentence, we saw my interest in eating meat died after I watched the documentary. So it's like, oh, I saw this documentary and my desire to eat meat went down quickly. Like it died, it stopped, it ceased. So that sounds like, oh no, I saw this documentary and I was done wanting to eat meat. So it kind of means to go away or to disappear. So especially with down, like to die down, that sounds extra gradual. Okay, good. Let's talk about the next one. Okay, so the second additional meaning for today's lesson is to stop working like a machine or a computer. Examples: my car is dying on the side of the road. Oh no! My phone battery died. Oh no, I have a graphic for this. Oh no, my phone battery died. It's not true. Okay. All right, anyway, so in both of these examples, we use die to mean that some machine or some device stopped working, usually because it ran out of power or because there's some technical malfunction. So in the first example, my car is dying on the side of the road, there could be a number of reasons why the car is dying. Maybe it's out of gas, maybe there's like a technical problem, maybe it's just, I don't know, something else has gone wrong, we don't know. But for whatever reason, the car is not moving or the car is not functioning correctly. So the car is dying on the side of the road. In the second example, a very common one, oh no, my phone battery died. In the past tense, it means my phone ran out of battery, my phone ran out of power, out of energy. So we say my phone died. We don't even need to say battery, just my phone died is perfect. That's a very natural sentence. Oh no, my phone died. So those are a couple additional meanings. Excellent. Now, let's go on to some variations for the verb die. So the first variation I want to talk about is to die of an emotion or to die of a feeling. So this is an expression we use when we feel that thing, that emotion, that sensation, very strongly. So strongly, we feel like we could die of, or we can also say die from that thing. Examples: I could die of happiness. And I'm dying of hunger. So in the first example, I could die of happiness. That's an example where we could substitute of for from. So I could die from happiness. That's also okay. We could say I could die of embarrassment, or I could die from embarrassment, or sadness, or loneliness, something like that. It's an emotion we feel so strongly, we feel like we could die because of it. In the second example sentence, I use the progressive. I'm dying of hunger. It means I'm so hungry, I feel like I could die. But I'm using the progressive tense, which means I feel this way now. I'm dying now because I'm so hungry. Dying of hunger means at this moment, you are dying. Well, not literally, but you are so hungry, you feel like you're dying. I'm dying of hunger. All right, let's go on to the next thing. So, let's go on to the next variation. The next variation is to be dying to verb. So, to be dying to do something. Examples. So, to be dying to do something means you have a very, very strong desire to do that thing. You really, really want to do this thing. So, examples of that. I'm dying to see that movie. He's dying to go home. So in both of these sentences, you see I'm using the infinitive form of the verb after dying. He's dying to, she's dying to, I'm dying to do something. We need to use to plus the verb. That's the infinitive form of the verb. So dying to do that thing means the speaker or the subject really, really wants to do that action, that verb. So that's what it means to be dying to do something. You're not actually dying. It just means you have a strong desire to do that thing. All right, good. So, those are a few variations, a couple of additional meanings. I hope that you picked up some new ways to use the verb die. If you have any questions or comments, or if you know a different way to use the verb die, or if you just would like to try to make an example sentence, please feel free to do so in the comment section of this video. Of course, don't forget to give us a thumbs up if you liked the video, subscribe to our channel if you have not already, and check us out at EnglishClass101.com for some other good study resources. Thanks very much for watching this episode of Know Your Verbs, and we'll see you again soon. Bye! Die! Dying to be alive. Yeah. That's a Hanson song. Anybody listen to Hanson? This is how I express a strong desire to do something. I go like this.